morning, what was my main worries? And they're all on this page. They're all on this page. This is it. And they're kind of in order too, if you go across. So separation events are key. Whenever you take something and you change where it is in space on purpose, you gotta worry about it. If these things don't separate, we've got a huge problem. If the last doesn't come off, we've got a huge problem. And then within that, there's a lot of, all those, on this particular flight, there's six mechanisms that attach the CM to the SM. All of those have to fire and come apart. The reorientation, when you come through on parachutes, you've got to separate the top cover that isn't on this mock-up, the forward bay cover, and that comes away on chutes with a separation mechanism that fires it off really fast. Then the chutes have to come out in a multi-stage effect. There's a bunch of activities there. And so there's a lot of mechanisms. And really, this flight is about testing out all those mechanisms in the kind of environment that you see. We've done wind tunnel tests. We've done all kinds of vibration tests. We've done environmental tests. But this is the next level of understanding of what you get there. Heat shield, I talked about that. This is my second thing. They're equal. This says 1.6 inches thick. When you start out and it erodes away, you know, we have to trade mass for capability. And there's some vehicles that are doing just LEO in return. They slather on a whole lot of heat shield to be extra conservative, be extra safe, and they can cut corners on some of the design if you have extra conservatism. We're pushing everything. We're pushing all the way out to wherever we're going. So you got to be real smart. And this is the largest heat shield ever made. It's larger than anything anybody else is doing, and it's got to survive a very dynamic environment to get the job done. So we want to make sure that's working. And the assembly of that, the buildup of that, we've learned a lot on EFT-1, and we're going to apply that to slight tweaks here and there to EM-1 and EM-2 to make it even better. Radiation, we talked about we're going to fly through the Van Allen belts twice. That's a very dynamic, high particle, high single event upset environment that you can get to from a radiation standpoint. We've designed our electronics and our avionics to be in that environment. This is our chance to test that hardening and see if that actually does well. And in addition to that, it's built to see a single event upset and automatically reset itself. Plus, we have redundancy and capability so that, but the whole architecture, you want to make sure you understand it. So you want to fly through that environment. Again, we've tested it on the ground as much as we can. Parachutes, part of the mechanisms, but also parachutes in themselves are a very dynamic and exciting experience. And we've done a ton of drop tests. I was out at one in Yuma, and it's an amazing thing to go through and experience. But seeing them do the real thing is going to be worth it.